Richard Scase. He's one of the world's leading business forecasters, addressing broadest global trends in business and around. His academic and research interests range from organizational change and entrepreneurship to the impact of internet technologies. He's an entrepreneur, he's a journalist, an author, and he was recently voted, incidentally, one of the top 10 most influential people in Britain on personnel and human resource management issues by Personnel Today. So, the world of work in 25 years' time, Richard Scase.
Britain in the future, and we were looking in that context at ageing. And this took me on then to looking at issues to do with the future, not just in terms of ageing, but in terms of other matters as well. Like I got labelled as being a futurologist, so you're a futurologist, is the question I often get put to me, accompanied with a smirk. What is a futurologist? I don't know. What I do is look at broader trends, economic trends, social, ecological trends, and look to see how these affect changes in society, how these then affect markets, and then how these then affect opportunities for particular kinds of businesses. And to take up immediately some points raised by Baron Scrimmage, is the issue about the age of the population. That's one major demographic change that's occurring in the United Kingdom. We just changed the sound on the microphone, please. And that's just one major change. There's another significant change that's occurring as well, which again has huge opportunities and implications on business opportunities. And that is the tremendous growth of single-person households. The growth of single-person households, particularly amongst those over the age of 40, over the age of 50, and indeed over the age of 60. And it's driven by a number of factors, really. Amongst the very old, it's driven by differences in life expectancy between men and women. But amongst the over 50s, being driven by the gender revolution, and men and women, quite simply, hating the men they live with. And I'm sure that the women with us this morning can think of all sorts of reasons why they should be hating the men that they live with. So we have a situation in London, for example, equally so as in Berlin, as in San Francisco, as in Los Angeles, and the major capital cities of the world, where the predominance of households are single-person households. And the ramifications of that for business opportunities, and the ramifications of that for housing, the ramifications for transportation, the ramifications for lifestyle and the delivery of products and services to those people, of course, is absolutely significant. It's a silent revolution. And incidentally, what I did do in a report in 2000, projecting what the UK would look like in 2010, was that there would be the growth of online communities. I wish I'd then gone ahead and put that thought into practice, hence I'd be over on Facebook by now. But what was also interesting is that following that idea through, we now have more people on online dating agencies than there are single people between the ages of 60 and 65. So something odd is going on there in terms of the number of people registering on dating agencies and so on. But let that as it be. If we look at some broader demographic trends, as I said, the growth in single person households associated with the aging of the population. What does that mean in terms of care, welfare, state provision, state benefit, etc. and so forth? Huge and enormous. The state will be unable to provide those services, hence, therefore, business opportunities. But if we extend that somewhat more broadly to look at the global situation, by 2035, the world's population will be 8 million. You say, well, so what? The projection is going to 10 million by 2050. In a sense, it doesn't matter. But it does, because it's not 8 million. Is more like 25 billion. Now what am I talking about? 25 billion, not 8 billion. Because it's projected that in the poorer regions of the world, living standards will increase. And living standards will increase such, therefore, the use and the demand for global resources will be that much greater in terms of foodstuffs, but also in terms of energy, in terms of water, and in terms of consumer products in general. So we're talking about, by 2035, we're not talking about 8 billion, we're probably talking about equivalent to something like 25 billion. And hence, therefore, it's been argued by some observers, including the chief scientific advisor of the government, that we face a perfect storm in about 20 years' time. A perfect storm in that will be running out of water, will be one of the key issues there. But also, if we look further into the future, we run out of oil in about 25 to 30 years' time. We run out of gas in 75 years' time. We run out of coal. In fact, we want to run out of coal in 200 years' time. So we have real challenges of that sort. And hence, therefore, the future is, in a sense, very worrying.